Hello and welcome to the virtual lab tour for the General Chemistry Lab 105. If you're looking for Stovall Hall, it's to the right of Minerva when you're facing her. So when you get to Stovall, notice how there's going to be signs for traffic, one-way traffic. So if you're going in, it's these two doors, and if you're leaving, it's these two. We're going to go upstairs to the chemistry department, which is right up here, and to the right. So once you walk through the building and pass the lecture hall, you're going to notice the stairwell directly to your right when you pass through. You go on up, and that's the chemistry wing. All right, so we're here in the chemistry department, and you can see the board here, which will show you that you're in the right place. Right here to the left is the stock room. This is my office, your lab coordinator. And then down here is where you'll find the lab, Stovall 315. All right, now so that I have you in the lab, you can see we have two exits in the front of the room, one to the left and one to the right. So in the event of a fire, an emergency, you're going to go out these doors and hang either a right or a left, depending which door it is, and you're going to go downstairs and take the first exit out. We are directly in the center of the hallway, so it doesn't matter which side you walk out of the building. So you'll notice right here to the left of the room, we have our spot where we have our gloves, our spill kit in the event that you spill a chemical or solution. We have our Kim wipes and our recyclable gloves. These gloves are recyclable, and what we do is we dispose them specifically in these bins. So make sure not to throw them in the trash or the regular standard recycling. You'll notice that the lab has three separate lab benches. Each lab bench has a different size. So to mind social distancing, we're having approximately one person and two people set up for each sides of the bench. This will allow 6 feet in between each person working in the lab. On this side of the room by the sink, you'll notice that we have our emergency eyewash station. In the event that you get a chemical splash into your eyes, you're gonna wanna come over here, place your face over the eyewash and push forward on this lever. This will allow a light stream of water to come up, and it'll allow you to flush your eyes for about 15 minutes in the event that something does get in. Your instructor will be advising you on how long to rinse and if there's any follow-up to do with that. All right, and then if we come over here, we can find the hood up in the front of the room. This is where we do our collections and discards for each lab. So at the end of each lab, before you're all done and leave the room, we're gonna have you take your solutions and anything that's considered discard, and it'll be collected over here. Up front, we also have our fire extinguisher, which can be used in the event that there is a fire in the lab. That's small and can be contained. As we go to the back of the room, we have two different pieces of PPE. We have our emergency shower. This is in the event that a concentrated acid gets on your clothes or skin. If it's a fair amount, we'll have you stand under the shower and pull this lever, which will allow a deluge of water to come down on you and rinse and dilute whatever you may have on you. Over here, we also have an emergency eyewash shower, which works the same when you're pushing the lever forward, and it'll allow that fountain to come out. We also have our fire blanket, which is right here. And in the event that someone gets caught on fire, a garment, we'll be using this. It's important to remember to wear clothing that is close to your body and not loose. Form-fitting stuff really helps, and we also have lab coats if you'd like to wear one of those. While we're back here, you'll notice we have our broken glass disposal. This is here if you break glass that doesn't have any residue on it, we'll take it here to this box. If you have glassware that has residue, we have a black bucket up to the front where we'll collect that as well. If your glassware has residue on it, you're going to want to use this black bucket for residue glass. And this is up in the front, part of the gloves disposal.